Hello, my name is Abiodun Mustafa. Welcome to this Special Purpose Masterclass. Special Purpose Masterclass, where you will be learning how to discover your genuine life purpose quickly and live fulfilled for the rest of your life. How to discover your genuine life purpose quickly and live fulfilled for the rest of your life. Have you always imagined and looked at the fact that I'm tired of the kind of life I'm living? I wish I could give more. I wish I could get more. I wish I could release more to my world. But you don't even know why you are on earth. That's why I'm here. I will be telling you on pointers that would enable you find your genuine life purpose, not an audio life purpose, not those who just say purpose statement that they don't really know what it should be, not just those who they ask. You will not just be that person who they ask you what's your life purpose and you are like, okay, you just want to say something, but how to find a genuine life purpose you should be pursuing and how you can live fulfilled for the rest of your life. My name is Abiodun, and who am I? I'm a personal development expert who have gone at this time. This is currently October 2020 when I'm recording this video. So as at this very time, I've helped over 800 people find, fulfill, and live their life purpose. And there are a measure of massive testimonials that have come out of it. Some were just confused, who don't know where to go. Some who left school, and they are like, they don't know the next thing. And I've been able to help over 800 plus people through my trainings, online courses, through my events, and through my coaching program. And I would be showing you exactly how you can discover your genuine life purpose quickly, not just, you need to go through one long process, how you can find it quickly and live fulfilled for the rest of your life. And if you stay to the end of this video, I have a free gift for you. So if you watch this video for the end, I have a free gift for you, and it's free. All right, what would you learn from this video? You would go learn the pointers for discovering your life purpose faster and clearly. No confusion, no hassle, no trying to, oh, what's it? What do I do? Do I still need to do? No, it's going to be fast and clear, all right? Number two, you're going to learn how to use them to know exactly what purpose you should be living. How do you utilize each of these pointers to know what purpose you should be living? And then I would be showing you a free gift, free ebook that you will be accessing at the end of this video. Now, let me ask you right now, how old are you? How old are you? I want you to write it down. Get a notepad, get a pen right now. How old are you? All right, maybe currently you're writing 23, 25, 30, 40, maybe you are even 50. Right now, how old are you? Now, after writing how old are you, the next thing I want you to do is, within those ages, how many things have you done that made you fulfilled? How many things have you done that made you fulfilled? How many things have you done that made you fulfilled? All right. Number three, I want you to write down, what are the things you keep dreaming of doing that you have still not done? What are the things you keep dreaming of doing that you have still not done? All right. Now, why I'm asking that question is that there is a very deliberate saying that I came across at the point that says that the genesis of your existence is your birth, but the genesis of your living is your discovery of purpose. The genesis of your death, of your existence is the day you were born, but the genesis of your living is the day you discovered a purpose for living. Now, which means that particular age you have written down, maybe 20, 25, 35, 40, that you have written down, would you say you have spent those number of years living or existing? Will you say you have spent those number of years living or existing? Which means if you are 25, if you are 30, if you are 25, if you are 35, or you are 32, irrespective of the age that you are, if you have still not found a purpose for living, it means you have existed for that number of years, but you have never fulfilled your purpose even for one day. We see a lot of people who come out every day on social media saying, oh, I'm 25. Oh, celebrate me. I say, congratulations. Happy birthday. But the rejoicing and congratulations is just for existence. They have not started living. So the essence of this video, like I said, is to help you discover your genuine life purpose quickly and live fulfilled for the rest of your life. Are you ready? Number one way to find your purpose, the first pointer is pain. Pain has to do with your past experiences, those past experiences you have overcome, that you have been healed from, which you desire to help others overcome or get healing. So what are some of your past experiences? Maybe in the past, you have found out that you have always been jilted in relationship. Every time you try a new relationship, they keep jilting you. The guys always keep lying to you until eventually you have been able to overcome, and then you got somebody who you went through a relationship with, and now you have been healed from it. And every time you see such story, you have this endless desire to help other people overcome it through the process you went through, through the personal transformation that happened in you, and then you want to help other people overcome it. So number one pointer that can help you find your purpose in life faster is your pain. So the pain you have gone through, the pain you have experience. Maybe at a time when you were young, you struggled so much financially, but you were able to figure out financial freedom, financial experiences, financial transformation that lifted you. All right, that's a way of knowing what purpose you should fulfill. You must have heard the story of someone like Robert Kiyosaki. At a point, he grew up from a very poor background. He grew up from a poor home, and then he had a poor father who was experienced, who was knowledgeable, but they were poor. They never had financial freedom. And then he also had a rich father, like an adopted father, who he always learned financial principle from. And Robert Kiyosaki went from a broke intellect pilot to somebody who is now financially free. All right, that's the story of one person. Maybe that's also your own experience. So there's that point of pain, and you can see reach that point that went out to sell millions of copies and is still selling today. All right, you may have heard of stories of other individuals in the world like that. Robert Kiyosaki is just somebody I mentioned. So you will find out that there's that point of pain which you have been transformed by. Let me share with you my own story. Before 2014, I was at a point where before I found my purpose in 2014 as a teenager, there was a time which I really, really wanted to attempted suicide. Like two times I attempted suicide as a teenager. I wanted to kill myself. I wanted to use the rope. I wanted to use the knife. But all this did not happen. It was only because I did not know my purpose, because I saw every external thing as the reason why I needed to live. So when I didn't get love externally, I didn't get love from people, I felt there was no essence to live a life. So I wanted to commit suicide. So it pained me so much that I did not find my purpose on time until I went to the National Youth Service Corps program. So NYC, National Youth Service Corps program, is a program for every graduate in Nigeria to serve the government in another state or in a particular region, sometimes away from your region, sometimes from the region you are used to, in order for you to learn the culture, in order for you to be impactful. Not until then, in 2014, when I became intentional about finding my purpose, I was still not having that measure of fulfillment that I wanted. So I started asking questions, I started reading books, I started praying, and then that my purpose was realized, that it was in purpose. So my own pain, that I was pained that I was born, my parents could not show me my purpose. I was pained that I passed through a lot of leaders, religious leaders, they were not able to help me in my purpose, now became my own assignment to help every other person in. So maybe you are in the past, you have been raped, but you have overcome that rape, you have been healed from it, and then you keep having this desire to help every other person overcome it. It's already a purpose you should be fulfilling. It could even be that in the past you failed academically, you were that kind of person that you never did well academically, you never performed performed so well. But every time you see people, every time you see individuals who keep failing, you have this desire that I wish I could help them. I wish I could show them the secret to academic excellence. I wish I could support them and enable that they do well. So your pain is a pointer to your purpose. All right, are you ready for number two? Number two is your passion. Number two is your passion. So your passion is a consistent burden, a consistent drive, or a consistent desire to solve a specific problem in your environment. All right, to solve a specific problem in your environment. And many times it may not necessarily come from your experience. It may not necessarily come from your experience. It may not necessarily be something you have gone through, but every time you see that problem, you have this desire to ensure that you solve it. Could it be that every time you go around, you keep having this desire that, oh, I wish I could help young people. I wish I could stop injustice. I wish I could stop illegality. That's the reason why a lot of people go to study courses like law. Not necessarily because they want to be rich studying law, but because they are passionate about causing an effect. I have a friend who is a lawyer who currently was called to bar this year. And in trying to discuss with her, she was somebody who was just passionate about human rights activists. So she wanted to help children and women. And that was her reason for going into law. So it's not necessarily because she chose that profession because it's something that she thought she would make money from. But she's passionate about solving the problem around human rights activism and all of that. So you could have this consistent burden, this drive that gives you the desire to solve a specific problem. For example, a person like Dale Carnegie, who is this individual that's the author of How to Win Friends and Influence People, you'll find out that he wrote his book in order to enable people gain expression. Why? Because he looked all around and saw how people were limited in getting opportunity, and he started writing books in relationship and public speaking. That could be something you're passionate about. Are you passionate about making young people? Maybe because you see that young people come out and they have this unusual sexual desire that become abused and that become molested, that become destroyed at the end of the day. And many of them have gone into regretful situations. You may not have been abused sexually. You may not have gone through sexual experiences that made you abused, but you are so passionate. You are so burdened. You have the desire that wants to make you address that problem. And it's not something that comes just once at a time. It's something that you found out that it is consistent. You see that word, it is consistent, a consistent burden. You sleep at night, you think about it. Every time maybe you're thinking, you keep getting bothered about it. Keep looking, how can I address this problem? How can I ensure that this gets better? How can I ensure that I can help the young people? How can I ensure that I can address this? Or probably you see how a lot of young people go into relationship because they don't get love from their homes. You may become passionate to address this problem, but you will find out that it has to be something that is what? Consistent. All right, number three is your potential. So your potential are your gifts, your skills, your talents, and ability, which you have found easy to use, easy to release in making the lives of others better. Take note, it's something that you do easily and it makes the lives of others better. It's not just something that makes your life better. It's not just something that you think of, oh, because this can make me money. No, it's something that you find out that it will make the life of others better. And you must realize that your purpose many times is not about you. Your purpose is about the people that it is meant for. All right, your purpose is not always about you. It's about the people that you are sent to. So what's that gift that you get? Maybe you find it very easy to talk to people. And when you find out that you speak to people, it creates a kind of inspiration in them. Sometimes they don't want to take actions. And you just found out that, oh, someone listens to you and then acts on something and it produces results. Or sometimes is it that you sing. When you sing, people are inspired. People are moved. Somebody who has been in pain became so ill. Somebody who is discouraged, the person became became challenged and motivated to take action. It means you've gotten that gift, that skill to be able to accomplish something. Or maybe sometimes you find it that your gift gives you the ability to inspire people in relationship. You just have this flair for talking about relationship. And when you talk about it, people just become sensible. Somebody who is almost about taking a foolish decision becomes just wise. All right, so that's a gift that you need to realize that it's a pointer to the purpose you should be fulfilling. And you should always realize that the potential in you is embedded to fulfill a purpose. All right, I'll go over that again. The potential in you is embedded in you to fulfill a purpose. All right, the potential in you is given to you to fulfill a purpose, and you'll find out that your potential always aligns, always matches up, all right, to your purpose. All right, for example, if your purpose is to help people who are molested and they want to be healed and get their self-esteem, you'll find out that your potential many times will have to do with speaking, many times we have to do with counseling. All right, you necessarily don't need singing to accomplish that. All right, you necessarily don't need to maybe be a very good actor or be a dramatic person to accomplish that. So your potential many times ties to the purpose that you should fulfill. Pointer number four is people. All right, the category of people you consistently find fulfillment being reaching out to. All right, you consistently find fulfillment when you reach out to them with your gift, with your skills, and with your ability. All right, maybe sometimes you just find fulfillment being amongst children. It may necessarily mean that your purpose has to do with children. All right, maybe sometimes you just find out that when you find yourself amidst those in secondary school, in the secondary education level, and when you reach out to them, you're invited to speak to them, you are volunteering towards doing things for them, you just find fulfillment doing those things. You just find yourself just being happy, even if you are not paid, even if you are not commended, even if you are not rewarded. You just find out that you have this consistent fulfillment when you reach out to those kind of people. All right, so people is a pointer to the purpose you should be fulfilling. All right, so what you have to do right now, all right, I've taken pointer 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now let's go back. Pointer number one, what you have to do, write out all the past experiences that pained you. What are all the previous experiences that pained you that you found out that it made you cry? All right. Now, number two, what are out of each of those experiences, how many of them have you been able to overcome and have you been healed from? Sometimes maybe you had an experience in the past that made you cry, that made you weep. If you have still not healed from them, then you cannot automatically say that's a purpose, because it takes somebody who have been healed to heal others. It takes somebody who have been healed to heal others. All right. So what are those past experiences that pained you, that hurt you? What are the past things people have done that hurt you? You write them down, and then you now begin to underline. You begin to underline which of all of these past experiences have you been healed from? All right. And then which of them would you be willing to communicate to others in order to help them from? All right. Number two, we talked about passion. You then need to write down what are those things you are passionate about, that every time there's something you are consistently thinking about helping others accomplish. All right. You look at your environment. What are the things that are going wrong? You begin to write them out. Okay, every time I keep thinking about how to solve this problem, every time I keep thinking how to help you to achieve academic excellence, every time I keep thinking on how to help people make the right career choices, every time I keep thinking of how to help people go into the right relationship, every time I keep thinking on how to help people experience the right development in themselves in order for them to be better to the world. All right, you list out all the things you are passionate about. Number three, you then write out what are all the potentials, what are all the gifts and skills and talents you've got. You can speak, you can write, you can act, you can coordinate, you can lead, all right, you can innovate. So what are all the gifts and skills that you've got? And then number four, people. Who are the people that when you are giving an assignment to them, or you find yourself being amidst them, you are always happy doing those things to them? Children, youth, single ladies, single men, married people, aged people, all right? Who are those people that when you're giving assignment towards them, it consistently gives you joy, all right? So the pointers, pain, all right? The pointers, pain, passion, potential, and what? and people. And people. Did you get value from there? Can you go to the comment section now and let me see that you can say value. All right. Value there. All right. Number five is problem. Number five pointer to finding your life purpose quickly is problem. Have you been in a situation where you walked into a place or maybe you've been in a place for a particular time and somebody had a particular problem and the person came to you without having a previous awareness whether you can solve that problem or not? Maybe, for example, people love coming to you and telling you, sister, I don't know what's happening. And I have a lot of brothers who are disturbing me in the church. I don't know what to do, man. Even if the person never knew that you could talk about that thing. And not one person, not two, not three, not four. Many a times, 10 people have come to you before on that specific area. It could be relationship. Sometimes someone just comes to you and say, I don't know the right career to choose. I'm just confused at this time. And you find out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 people, they consistently come to you to solve that problem. So problem is the consistent kind of problem people seek you for solution without prior awareness of whether you can help them out or not. So what are the kind of problems people keep coming to you? All right, they keep coming to you, they keep asking you, I need solution in this area. They reach out to you via DM. Sometimes they send a WhatsApp message. Sometimes they just interact with you. Sometimes they just try to reach you. Sometimes they call you and say, please, I need help. You understand? And it's not like before you've told them you can solve that problem. It's a pointer to the purpose you should be fulfilling. So you need to pay attention to it. You need to sit down right now and begin to say, what's that consistent problem that people come to me and they keep saying they need help? They keep coming to me and they say, they need assistance. They keep coming to me and they keep saying, I need them. I need support. I need assistance in this area. It's a pointer to the purpose you should be fulfilling. All right. Sit down right now and write down all the area of pain. Write down all the area of passion. Write down all the potential you've got. Write down all the people you find fulfillment reaching out. And then write out the consistent problems that people come to you for solution. All right, have you gotten value? That it's very, very, very quick way. It's not a lot of people will sit down, I want my life purpose. They are sitting down, they say, they want one angel to come and say, lo and behold, these are things you should do. No, these are quick pointers for you to find your life purpose. And you should always realize that majority of the people who are born on earth, all right, not every one of us had the privilege for our parents to help us to know our life purpose before we're born. Not every one of us had the privilege for an angel, a voice, a supernatural experience to come to us so that we would know the purpose that we should fulfill. A number of times, many of us took deliberate efforts, asking the producer, seeking from him, looking for answers to questions that made us find our life purpose. All right, I have a free gift for you. It's a free ebook I did titled Purpose Clarity Blueprint. All right, you are going to find the untold yet simple secrets for discovering and living a life of purpose. Purpose Clarity Blueprint. I've got a lot of downloads already, and I want you to get your copy. So what you have to do, go to the description section right now and download your copy. It's absolutely free and you should get it. Don't forget to send your review when you're done reading, and also let me know how much this blessed you. All right, don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more valuable sessions, for more valuable videos, for more impactful sessions that will transform your life. All right, subscribe, make sure you like this video, make sure you comment, and make sure you share it. Get it to as much as possible. Every individual who you know, all the friends you have, all your contacts, send this video to them, for in that you are fulfilling your purpose already. Do you have any questions from all that have been shared? Drop in the comment section. I will be waiting to see them and answer them. If I can't answer them through the comment section, I will do a video in order to answer them. So that's why you need to subscribe. Till I come your way again, I remain Abiodun Mustafa, your personal development expert. Bye-bye.